Hi, and welcome to the Shared Shelf Fiction Book Club at the Allen Public Library. I'm Abby.
And I'm Kristen, and today we'd like to talk about our January title, Pride, Prejudice, and Other Flavors by Sonali Dev. Here's a synopsis. Award-winning author Sonali Dev launches a new series about the Rajays, an immigrant Indian family descended from royalty who have built their lives in San Francisco. It is a truth universally acknowledged that only in an overachieving Indian American family can a genius daughter be considered a black sheep. Dr. Trisha Rajay is San Francisco's most acclaimed neurosurgeon. That's not enough for the Rajays, her influential immigrant family who's achieved power by making its own non-negotiable rules. Number one, never trust an outsider. Number two, never do anything to jeopardize your brother's political aspirations. And number three, never ever defy your family. Trisha is guilty of breaking all three rules, but now she has a chance to redeem herself, so long as she doesn't repeat old mistakes. Up-and-coming chef DJ Kane has known people like Trisha before, people who judge him by his rough beginnings and place pedigree above character. He needs the lucrative job the Rajays offer, but he values his pride too much to indulge Trisha's arrogance. And then he discovers that she's the only surgeon who can save his sister's life.
So we asked our readers for some feedback on this really fun book and on any other romance title that they may have read this past year. So our reader Emily, her feedback on Dev's book is both characters initially suffered from the woe is me syndrome, taking deep personal responsibility for things out of their control. Trisha's is compounded by her family's expectations. So I recommend therapy for both of them, she says. They do learn how to open up a little and trust each other, which was nice to see. The food aspect really made me miss family get-togethers. The act of breaking bread together is so important to creating and maintaining bonds. What I loved most was the passion DJ had for his cooking, which he was able to share with Trisha. I'm a sucker for a romantic hero who takes on some of the nurturing aspects so often assigned to the female character. More beta heroes, please. I think Sonali Dev managed to balance the tone and main story points of Pride and Prejudice with fresh characters and so many cultural layers. Made me want to rewatch the Bollywood version of Pride and Prejudice. Oh, yeah, that's a good movie.
Okay. This was also one that I really enjoyed. This was the first Pride and Prejudice rewrite that I didn't groan when I read. I really enjoyed it. The gender switch, where Trisha is the one with the wealth and status, updated the story and gave it a fun modern twist. I also loved how they intertwined food and culture into the story, like Emily mentioned. I loved reading about the Rajay family and how close they are despite everything that happens to them and everything they make happen. This would make a tremendously entertaining movie.
Yes, I agree. I'd love to see this as a movie. Yes. I think this is one of my new favorite Pride and Prejudice retellings, at least for right now, probably at least until I read her next book. And it just feels more modern and fun. And yes, I really enjoyed the gender swap reversal, where Trisha is the one that comes from the wealth and DJ is the one that grew up poor. But I also liked that this, what Dev did for Trisha, she didn't just make her arrogant just because of her wealth. She also, it was because she's a very renowned neurosurgeon. So that's most where a lot of her arrogance and kind of self-worth comes from when her dealings with when she first meets DJ. So I liked that there was something else, that she wasn't just a snob because she was from a wealthy family. It was also different that she was also from the big close-knit family, kind of like in the original with Elizabeth and the Bennets, and is DJ that just has the sister. But I did warm up to Trisha a little more eventually, but not right. But she wasn't my favorite character right away, just like Mr. Darcy in the original. And I also really enjoyed, just reading about DJ and his sister, about how they grew up poor and his experiences. But it was cooking and food that really helped him get through it. And also for his sister Emma, it was her painting. I just love learning about these different art cultures and how they can be just as important as certain other big careers, like, doctors. There we go.
Okay. Sonali Dev has written a follow-up to this book entitled Recipe for Persuasion, which Abby alluded to. It was published earlier this year and tells the story of Chef Ashna Rajay, Trisha's cousin, who is introduced in the book we discussed. They mentioned her briefly in the book. I read it recently and really enjoyed the twist on persuasion. And rather than a medical focus, it's set in the world of reality cooking shows, which was a fun update. The author has also written a third book in the series, which will be released this summer, called Incense and Sensibility. I just read an early digital copy, and it tells the story of Yash Rajay, Trish's older brother, and his journey to find love while running for governor in California in a highly contested and sometimes dangerous race. This one is a modern take on Jane Austen's popular story, Sense and Sensibility. And I follow the author on social media, and I told her that I had read it and how much I enjoyed it, and she actually responded to me with some big high fives and hearts and little smiles, so that was pretty cool.
That's so cool. All right, and also according to the author's website, Sonali's novels have been on Library Journal, NPR, Washington Post, and Kirkus's Best Books of the Year list. She's won the American Library Association's Award for Best Romance, the RT Reviewer Choice Award for Best Contemporary Romance, multiple RT Seals of Excellence, and is a Rita finalist and has been listed for the Dublin Literary Award. Shelf Awareness calls her not only one of the best, but one of the most bravest romance novelists working today.
Okay, let's talk again in March to discuss The Dutch House by Anne Patchett, any other title by this author, or any other literary fiction title you'd like to read.
And we'd like to leave you today with one question. What is your favorite romance novel of all time? So please leave your choice in the comments below. Thanks for listening today.